Namaskar. I am Anoop Kumar Rajput and I am Professor of Mathematics Education in NCERT. I will be talking to you on the module which has been prepared on Pedagogy of Mathematics.
Namaskar, I am Dr. A.K. Vazalwar. I am Professor in Mathematics in DESM NCERT New Delhi and I will be talking to you about the module Pedagogy of Mathematics.
So friends, as has already been told to you that we will be talking on Pedagogy of Mathematics, and certainly when we talk about learning of children, the learning takes place in the same way whether it is mathematics or languages or any other subject. But mathematics has its peculiar nature and we will be talking about that also in beginning. One is, let us understand why mathematics is to be studied. What is the importance of studying mathematics? The one of the very important aspect of studying mathematics is that it is used to put quantification of our ideas. Like quantification of ideas means when we say distance between any two objects. Now, how much distance is? So, we need some number, something to describe that. Similarly, how many are these objects? Say, for example, how many are fingers? So, we need something to describe this. So, quantification of ideas, how much, what, this very important aspect. Second is that mathematics is precise in nature, and that nature simply is that when we say 2 plus 2 in a particular reference is 4 only, neither slightly less than 4 nor slightly greater than 4. So, therefore, that preciseness is in mathematics, and that preciseness somewhere gives an idea, but people somewhere understand that because mathematics is exact, therefore, we cannot talk about the approximation here, but that has very, very important validation and important application in our daily life when we approximate and when we say the distance between two objects, that certainly we cannot be so precise, we do not have instruments to measure. But we can say yes, whatever our requirement, we can be precise. If we are, our requirement is only up to one place of decimal, so we will say it is 3.1 centimeter or 3.2 centimeter or 3.3 centimeter. But if it is of places of two decimal, then we have to go more precise, more exact, similarly for three places and so on. So, that is what we mean by exactness or preciseness in mathematics. And third one is
utilization of the spatial concepts, the geometrical concepts that we find around us. We find many objects around us that require the knowledge of region, the knowledge of space. For example, if I take up this particular object, I can say that it has got a certain boundary here. And as we said, the quantification of ideas, how do we quantify this? When we quantify this, we call this the perimeter of this particular rectangular object. If I want to quantify this particular region here, I will say that it is the area of this particular region. So, the objects that are around us, we try to quantify these objects also, and these are the special objects that are occupying some position, some space in the in our environment, and that is why to know the properties of these objects, we have the spatial concepts that we study in geometry or in higher geometry, in coordinate geometry, so on and so forth. And for doing this, the basic thing that is required by a student is the growing of the inner resources of the child, the inner resources, not just the rote memorization that this is area, this is perimeter, this is volume, so on and so forth. But how it comes, how it is developed, that is more important. And so, the growing of inner resources has been laid more emphasis on.
Right. So, now we'll be talking to you on objectives of this module. Through this module, we'd like you to kindly look on to some competencies and skills which are required in mathematics, particularly in mathematics related to primary and upper primary classes. Why, what we want a child to do? When we say child should learn number, addition of numbers, so is it only specific to numbers, or we want some skill to be incorporated in the child so that child should be able to add any two groups whenever required and can give a number to that new group? So that skill is in focus, not the numbers. So that's why when we say development of competency in your skills, this module will give you some ideas about the development. Second is to relate competency and skills with the learning outcomes. As you know, learning outcomes have already been defined, and these learning outcomes are class wise and subject wise. But when we talk of competency and skills, they are away from the subject boundaries, they are away from the classes. So, competencies are developed over a period of time, inclusion of all experiences of the child. So, therefore, it is essential that through this module, you will be having an idea of how competency and skills are to be related with learning outcomes and syllabi.
Yes, we'll be talking about competencies a little later, but we have got, in order to achieve these competencies and skill, we have got the required pedagogical processes that are more important. How to deliver that particular concept, how to transact that particular concept, so that students get involved, they get engaged in that particular exploration for that particular concept, and they try to derive it for themselves. They try to get some idea about that particular concept. Even when a new concept is introduced, we do some activity through which the child at least gets some idea,
right,
that this is something about, something new about that. For example, if I want to introduce the concept of integers, I can talk about some context around me, that for example, giving and taking. I gave someone 10 rupees and I took some 10 rupees from someone, or a person moving to the left of a tree and a person moving to the right of the tree. There the quantities are involved, say 1 kilometer or 2 kilometers, whatever. Someone climbing up, say 15 stairs, someone climbing down 20 stairs. The thing that is to be brought out to the notice of the child is something opposite is happening there, and that is involving some quantity there. How to quantify that idea? And so the concept of, and then the child also realizes that the numbers that she has been using till now are of no use, say for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0, etc. So what kind of new coding has to be created? The child starts thinking about that. And that is what the pedagogical processes we mean, how to introduce the concept of integers through the activity-based method. And of course, while doing this, to integrate the assessment factor also, how much the child has learned earlier, but not just learned, but how the thought processes of the child works, so that she is able to at least get an idea of what could be that particular new concept that is being introduced, not just told to her that this is fraction or this is integers or this how to add fractions and so on. We don't intend to do that, but at least let the child get an idea about that concept, and then of course later on, at an appropriate stage, she can be told about it.
And moreover, it is very essential that now, through this module, we like to give an idea of how assessment is integrated with day-to-day teacher learning processes. Earlier, we were understanding that teacher has to teach, learner has to learn, and later on, we'll have assessment after the end of the class or maybe after certain 20-40 minutes of the class. But now, we understand that in assessment is to be integrated with day-to-day teaching learning processes, so that every time teacher is getting idea, maybe through observation, maybe looking into eyes of the children, maybe looking into the notebook when the children are doing, maybe listening to what children are speaking to each other, so that these all will give us idea how children are learning. And if there are certain learning gaps, teacher is in a position to find out learning gap as and when they are developing, so that inputs can be given. If child is not learning appropriately, input can be given immediately during that period only, maybe through collaborative learning, maybe through involving, engaging learners in some other engagement, some other activities and so on. But this teacher should have an idea that when I am teaching, continuously assessment is being done.
Yes. And assessment for what purpose?
Yeah.
Assessment to strengthen the learning of the child. Then and there the teacher comes to know after, I mean, there need not be a paper pencil test or an examination. While transacting a concept, when the teacher interacts with the children, she comes to know the thought processes of the children somewhere or the other. And then she tries to apply the processes that you are talking about.
And then now, in this module, we have talked about the competencies and how these competencies are to be developed among children. So what are the basic competencies in mathematics? Those, let's see. One of them is problem solving ability. For any type of problem, particularly using mathematical ideas, how mathematical ideas to be used. So therefore, our focus is not, say, for example, doing certain problems of profit and loss, but it is applying in life. How a problem of life is being addressed through problem solving, through mathematics, using a mathematical ideas. Say for example, if we say there is one shopkeeper who is giving me one buy one get one free, another shopkeeper is giving me 50% discount on everything whatever you buy. So which is beneficiary for me? I should be able to, or learner should be able to, apply mathematics, and that is what we call as competency. So therefore, when we are talking about competencies, we are talking something away from textbooks also. So not confining only textbooks. The second is reasoning ability. Children should be able to reason out their ideas, their insertions, their inferences. Why? Why 7 into 5 is 35? They should be able to give ideas, so that if they understand why 7 5s are 35, they can then develop what is 8 5s are, because 1 5 is to be added only in 7 5s are. So then all ideas interlinked and developed by each other. So therefore, this is another very important activity, ability in children, that they should reason out their assertions, why they are saying like this, if we change what will happen and so on. So that very important competency which we want every child should have, and that is developed through mathematics.
One more important thing is the observation of that particular process. while reasoning out something, because if I apply a particular reasoning in a particular context, and when I observe what is happening there, I try to structure my problem, I try to structure my solution accordingly, then my observation skills are also sharpened, and I am able to apply it in higher, doing the other concept also, particularly in higher mathematics as well. So my observation skills are also developed, and then I am able to apply the procedure, that is the applying the procedure's ability. For example, if a problem is given to me, I should be able to identify what are the concepts involved in this particular problem and how to apply these concepts. There could be one concept, there could be scores of concepts that are that could be applied, in what sequence they have to be applied, in what way they can, you can minimize your efforts while applying these concepts. These are all very interesting things. While doing this, the child should be able to enjoy this particular journey, and that is what we intend to do. And representation ability, all the symbols that we see, the numbers, the symbols, the diagrams, symbols for triangles, pictures, for shapes, everything. Why this particular symbol has been used? How to represent it? The number line is the beautiful example of representation, where we are trying to represent the numbers on a line, and then we are gradually increasing. We are, that denseness of that particular number line is increasing as we study newer and newer numbers. For example, we started with natural numbers, and we are showing it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. Then we are adding 0 to it on the number line. Then we are inserting the negatives of that on the left hand side of that. Then we are inserting the rational numbers, then the irrational numbers, and so on and so forth. And so the number line becomes denser and denser. And but that helps me in visualizing the concepts. It may not be an exact representation, but it does help me to the point, example of a point in geometry. What point we put on the board or the or on a paper, that point according to Euclid is not an ideal point that he has defined it, but that gives us an idea of what a point could be. We have constructed a line, it's a representation of a concept of line, representation of the concept of a ray, and the whole geometry is built upon that, the whole engineering concepts have been built upon that.
Moreover, when we talk about representation, it may be through symbols, it may be through pictures, it may be through models, many, many ways are there. So this connection, this ability of representation should be there. Second very important, or another important competency, is connecting all ideas. When we say talking about measurement of capacity of a vessel, we are talking about, say, for example, liquid. So we may even talk about the physics of the liquid, we may talk about the chemistry of the liquid, we may talk about the importance in our social life of the liquid, we may talk about the mathematical ideas of how capacity is measured and what are the units to measure this, and so on. So therefore, this connectivity child learns while we doing mathematics, not only interdisciplinary, but within mathematics also, how numbers are related with geometry, how geometry is related with coordinate geometry, and so on. So these all abilities should be there in child, and mathematics somewhere help child to have that connection. And then last one and very, very important is communication ability. When I have to communicate to you that I have these many objects and these many are more, now after combining how many are there, so if I know that these are called 4, this is called 3, and I say 4 and 3 are combined together and I will get 7. So in a precise manner, I am able to communicate that when 4 and 3, a group of 4 objects, another group of 3 objects is combined together, we get 7 objects. So this communication is very, very important, and mathematical language help us in having that communication.
Yes, vocabulary is the most important part of this, because unless and until every word of mathematics is understood properly in a proper context, I won't be able to communicate and I won't be able to relate it to the next higher concept that I am going to study. In fact, the higher concept doesn't remain a higher in that sense, but it is merely expansion of concepts. And so this communication, the interlinking of concepts with each other, becomes an enjoyable thinking process, that becomes an enjoyable thinking process, which the child should get a taste of it.
When children are coming to primary schools, obviously children learn with concrete objects in a better way. So therefore, we say that there should be a sequence of activities and experiences which are to be provided to the children, and that sequence we normally call is a ELPS. E is for experiences. So children should be given experiences of, say, for example, we are going to talk about addition of numbers with the children. So for example, there are 5 objects in a group and 3 more objects in another group. So we say that the 5 and 3 objects are joined together, child will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, will have experiences of counting again, recounting, and so on, combining. Then language, how the 5 and 3 making 8, child is then developing a language. Then child is having Say, for example, experiences. A lot of experiences through pictures have to be drawn. Our books start with pictures only. A picture of five objects is given, a picture of three objects is given, and we say counting and combined, where we have eight objects. Then we ultimately, in the end, we talk about symbols that 5 + 3 is equal to 8. But in our whole system, if you recall, we start with 5 + 3 = 8, and then we try to relate it with experiences, with language, and so on. Whereas if we do it other way, children will not be having any problem in quantifying and in having the idea of numbers. And similarly, we can have for upper primary also.
I mean, as you said about the symbols, it is playing an important role here. When you say 5 + 3 = 8, that plus represents combining of something, minus represent taking out something from something, some quantity from some other quantity. And when we extend it further and go to algebraic concepts, there we say simply x plus y. We are representing that particular procedure. And that representation of procedure is very important, that we are combining two quantities. What those quantities are, those domains have to be defined, that have to be talked about. And so, the pedagogical processes at upper primary stage contains the participation of students, the engagement of students. First of all, as we say, the experience has to be provided, that is, activity has to be given. And in that activity, students should participate joyfully. And while doing that, they get engaged in the initially in the concrete objects, but later on in the thinking process related to those objects. And then they observe the things, how these phenomena is happening, what kind of mathematical process is going on. These observations should start through conversation. Of course, this has to be brought to their notice. Then they make some hypothesis that it must be, if it is combining, or if it is you are combining two integers, suppose, how to do that, what should be the activity that conveys it. So this observation, then making hypothesis that if I say -5 + 3, then what could it be? Will it be a negative number? Will it be a positive number? Will it be 0? What can it happen? So let the students do it for themselves using these concrete objects, and then verify those, that hypothesis, and then related to that, the most important part, the problem solving. Visualization and representation is an important part in the initial stages, because unless and until through these concrete objects I am able to visualize the concepts, for example, the concept of point, line, rays, integers, fractions, these are all abstract concepts. There are certain principles behind that. So unless and until I am able to visualize it by after putting some symbol through it, when I say 2 by 3, it has got certain meaning. I am using the same symbols as 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. But 2 by 3 does not mean 2 or does not mean 3. That 2 by 3 symbol is a totally different concept, and that I should be able to represent and visualize.
And similarly, as we mentioned for primary classes also, and as the competencies in mathematics, making connections, important competency, which we certainly like to have, upper primary children should have. Similarly, systemic reasoning. All our activities should provide opportunities to children to systematize their reasoning, to provide why something is happening. If this will happen, this will happen, then this will happen, then this will happen. Say, for example, some angle sum of of a triangle is 180 degree. Why? Because when a line parallel to one side is drawn from opposite side, then the angles, alternate interior angles are equal, therefore they will be form a linear angle. That's why sum is this. So this why this is happening, that's why. Child should be able to make those all reasoning, systemic reasoning, and then mathematical connections.
Yes.
That is already there. So friends, this all is very, very important. We know that in this module you will be having ideas much more than these also. During these presentations, we try to make you some idea about the ideas written there. In these, we have given you examples, exemplars also. Say, for example, while angles are to be introduced to children, how it is to be done, and integrating everything, whatever we spoke.
So there are activities where the concept is introduced,
right.
There are activities where the concepts have to be reinforced. And while doing this, what kind of interaction the teacher should have with the children, so that children get engaged in the activity, get engaged in the mathematical thinking process. And that is the gist of our module for pedagogy of mathematics. We hope that the teacher, after going through this particular module, and when we transact this particular module and discuss with the teachers will definitely get some idea of how to make the classrooms dynamic classrooms, where children will be joyfully learning the concepts, getting involved in the mathematical process.
So friends, after this introduction, I hope you will be having some ideas. Now you please go through, read all these, and after reading, then discuss with the resource persons who are there with your in your program. They will certainly give you more idea about this. Thank you very much for listening to us. And yes, this journey is on. We may interact through other modes also. Thank you for be others.
Thank you. Namaskar.